The story so far. Agent 47 and his handler, Diana Burnwood, are the world's top assassins working for the ICA. When all of their recent missions turn out to be contracts for a shadow client, things take an unexpected turn. All their targets have been operatives in an invisible organization known as Providence. Providence has infiltrated the highest echelons of power and secretly owns our world. The Shadow Client wages a silent war against them. And so the Constant, Providence's enigmatic controller, seeks Diana out. His request, track down and eliminate the Shadow Client. In return, he offers something irresistible. The truth of 47's lost origins. Neither know that the man they hunt is 47's childhood friend. And unlike 47, he remembers everything.
Understood. Alma Raynard's house is just up the beach. Our intel indicates that she and her team are laying low, most likely planning the militia's next strike.
Raynard is one of the Shadow Client's top lieutenants, and yet she's not a target.
Not yet, anyway. She's no doubt high on our client's list, but for now, it's information we seek. Infiltrate the house and get us a lead on the Shadow Client. Up for some B&E, 47.
On my way. Bodies. Male and female. Early 30s. Executed.
I see them. Poor bastards. Looks like Reynard's grisly handiwork, all right. She was never shy about collateral damage.
The owners?
Don't think so. The house is registered to a non-existing environmental NGO. This feels more like identity theft. Like you, Reynard is known to use disguises. Keep looking, 47. Nothing we can do for these people now.
Found something. A file on Rupert Pierce, founder of Dynasty Global.
The world's largest internet retailer. If Pierce is a Providence operative, he's likely on the Shadow Client's hit list. But it's not what we came for. Keep looking, 47. That computer. See if you can't access it. Encrypted. Assuming there's a key, Reynard wouldn't just leave it lying around. Wait. According to the floor plan, the room you're in should be a lot bigger. There might be a concealed space behind the wall. Check for hidden panels, 47. Here we go. For the office computer, no doubt.
I'm in.
Hurry. I'm detecting movement up the road. A motorcade, possibly Reynard's.
Uploading the data.
Hold on. Receiving it now. Nothing on the Shadow Client or the other cells. No names, no aliases. I doubt she even knows whom she's working for. Wait, here's something. A message from Robert Knox of Kronstadt Industries. And by the sound of it, he's a Providence operative.
A defector.
Well, well, well. Client won't like this one bit.
And you can't wait to tell him. They're back. Multiple hostiles.
I see them. Damn. Got all we're going to get. Go to stage 2, 47. Eliminate Reynard, and preferably without raising suspicion. One step ahead of the Shadow Client for once. Let's keep it that way.
Ugh, I thought this night would never end. What a snob fest. And I even missed out on the action.
I'm sorry you had to endure all that free champagne and cello music, Orson. What can I say? You really took one for the team.
Yeah, well, I say stick to what you know.
Continuing search.
Clear! Nothing here, Command. Moving on.
Anybody copy? No sign of any pup. Moving on.
Oh, shit! I hit back!
Clear. Search the area. We have to find the perp. Yeah.
Keep those eyes peeled.
loud and clear.
He's scared. I heard someone crying. He's crying somewhere. Big baby.
The story so far.
At the location. No hostile presence.
Understood. Alma Raynard's house is just up the beach. Our intel indicates that she and her team are laying low, most likely planning the militia's next strike.
Raynard is one of the Shadow Clan's top lieutenants, and yet she's not a target.
Not yet, anyway. She's no doubt high on our client's list, but for now, it's information we seek. Infiltrate the house and get us a lead on the Shadow Client. Up for some B&E, 47.
On my way. Bodies, male and female, early 30s, executed.
I see them. Oh, poor bastards. Looks like Raynard's grisly handiwork, all right. She was never shy about collateral damage.
The owners?
Don't think so. The house is registered to a non-existing environmental NGO. This feels more like identity theft. Like you, Raynard is known to use disguises. Keep looking, 47. Nothing we can do for these people now.
Against police
Here we go. For the office computer, no doubt.
I'm in.
Hurry. I'm detecting movement up the road. A motorcade, possibly Reynard's.
Uploading the data.
Hold on. Receiving it now. Nothing on the Shadow client or the other cells. No names, no aliases. I doubt she even knows whom she's working for. Wait, here's something. A message from Robert Knox of Kronstadt Industries. And by the sound of it, he's a Providence operative.
A defector.
Well, well, well. Client won't like this one bit.
And you can't wait to tell him. They're back. Multiple hostiles.
I see them. Damn. Okay, we've got what we're going to get. Go to stage 2, 47. Eliminate Reynard, and preferably without raising suspicion. One step ahead of the Shadow client for once. Let's keep it that way.
Ugh, I thought this night would never end. What a snob fest. And I even missed out on the action.
I'm sorry you had to endure all that free champagne and cello music, Orson. What can I say? You really took one for the team.
Yeah, well, I say stick to what you know.
sign of any perp. Moving on. Command, nothing in my position. Over.
Understood.
Now!
Roger that.
Come on, come in. Your coffee? Yeah, I'm here now. No, nothing.
You better take a look at that explosion, boys. Let's go.
Loud and clear.
Got a situation here. Command, command, you there? Breach! Command, you read me? Over. Something detonated in the proximity.
Anybody copy? No sign of any pup.
Nothing to report from my current location. Over. Roof is clear. Moving on. Over.
Well done, 47. Now get off the property. It's official. New Zealand paid off. The client has given us carte blanche. Hunt down the militia by any means necessary.
A week ago, Providence was a threat. How did you swing the board?
The board are practical people, 47. A blank check is hard to turn down. Besides, the Shadow Client's war on Providence is causing a global panic. Someone will need to stop the militia. Might as well be us.
And the man on the train? You never told them about his offer.
Taking a contract for personal gain is against ICA regulations.
Sodas would have been proud.
Is that a sense of humor, 47? Whatever next? Crying at the movies?
Why are you doing this?
I know what it's like to have everything taken from you.
He claims to know about your past. Your childhood, your memories, everything Altmaier stole from you.
And you trust him?
About as far as I can throw him. But this is our best lead in 20 years. I say it's time we break a few rules.
Welcome to Miami, 47. The innovation race is on its last day, and it is down to the wire. Thousands of eager fans are gathered for the final laps of this unexpectedly close race. Sierra Knox is expertly piloting her red Kronstadt car. Her father, Robert Knox, roams the nearby expo building where Kronstadt is showcasing its new prototype car. The Kronstadt RK Mark III has seen fierce competition from the Chinese Kowloon Heavy Industries' new racer. Moses Lee, CEO of Kowloon, has taken a dominant lead and looks invincible. Sierra Knox will need to risk it all if she wants to win for the third year in a row. The stakes are as high as they can get.
Thank you. Shit! Somebody's been killed! Oh, no, 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 no!
Nothing here, Command. Moving on. Thank you.
figured I'd try out a new beat, you know?
I don't think you have options for me.
Don't know. This is my first gig. Never been to any of these races before, but it sure is loud. I heard something about a demo upstairs in the expo building, but it's off limits apparently.
Yeah, rubber down to the floor. Straight up to the floor.
How the smell of those tacos they're selling down by the water is driving you nuts with hunger?
No, no, that wasn't it.
Hey, you with Kronstadt? Can you believe this guy? What a flippin' dildo!
Apprehend. representative of personal stealth technology. It's a quantum leap in innovation.
Robert Knox down. Now for the heir to the Kronstadt Empire.
Holy shit. Hit me.
I got a body on the ground. It doesn't look good.
Race buffs out there, I can tell you that the winner will again be presented with champagne on the podium after a few years of regular sparkling wine. That is real champagne from the Eastern region of France. Fun fact of the day, folks. Don't forget, this race is all about getting some miles under the hood. It's as much about the car's stamina and technology as it is about the driver's talent.
Thank you.
Huh.
Down first. Oh, wait. Was there a touch? Or even a slight collision going into that corner? Oh, the stewards are going to have to take a close look at this one. that car going until the end. This race is not over until the clock ticks down.
One of the Kronstadt pit crew has quit the team in protest, and Grace Miller, the ballbuster chief mechanic, is in critical need of a replacement. Why don't you step in and offer your services, 47? You're good with a wrench. Inside the Kronstadt pit. I suggest you talk to Grace Miller, chief mechanic. She could probably use some extra hands.
For newcomers to endurance racing, let me remind you that this is different from Grand Prix in that it's all about which team can go the distance. Fuel efficiency and reliability.
Be mindful of roaming security guards. Some of them may work out you don't quite belong. Use the crowds to hide in if needed.
Look at the body. Look at how low these cars are. They are virtually on the ground. I mean, the level of technical engineering on display today. It's something very special.
Ship and I need a replacement ASAP. Are you available? Shit. All right, gotta run. Talk later.
Oh, shit, you.
You're the junior slip wrench who got injured yesterday, right?
Help! A
Santa.
He was dressed like those mechanics.
Big Ten 4.
Found someone on the ground. Don't know what's happened. I'll get back.
Race. You still at the race? I need to rub up this right now. He's tucked up already. Thanks anyway, buddy. Talk later. Nothing. I have no idea what that was.
Central. Hey, someone is on the ground. Don't know if they're hurt.
Out over here.
for newcomers to endurance racing, let me remind you that this is different from Grand Prix in that it's all about which team can go the distance. Fuel efficiency and reliability, that's the name of the game. This is...
Knox is going to be pissed. I did the pre-race checkup on her, and...
For newcomers to endurance racing, let me remind you that this
back
is different from Grand Prix.
You're starting to freak me out.
It's all about which team can go the distance. Fuel efficiency and reliability.
I'm telling you,
Miss
Knox is going to be pissed. I did the pre-race checkup on her, and... Well, let's just say she's got a bad case of intermittent explosive disorder.
Poor Dr. Sorensen. First, he almost loses a patient to a seemingly harmless case of dehydration. Now he has to deal with this guy suffering from urinary retention.
Well, the anticipation here is just so high. This is the place to be. The best track you'll ever see. The best Uber drivers we've had in a long, long time. And how about that crowd, huh? Awesome day of racing here in Miami.
At least we know who's buying his beer tonight.
Ain't that the truth?
Just repeat some ground rules for those of you...
Hey there, big guy.
You gotta cover as much ground as possible within the time frame. When the time...
Hey, paramedics, I'm not supposed to use this engine. Sorry.
a test of nerves going into that. Who backs down first? Oh, wait. Was there a touch? Or even a slight collision going into that corner? Oh, the stewards are going to have to take a close look at this one.
Oh, Doctor. Gosh, I'm so happy to see you. I'm guessing you're here to replace...
All you medics look alike. Scary.
Attention, Sierra Knox. Your vitamin and rehydration session has been delayed. More information will follow.
Oh, Doctor. Gosh, I'm so happy to see you. I'm guessing you're here to replace Dr. Sorensen. I forget your name, sorry?
Dr. Reaper.
Ah, yes, of course. Well, whenever you're ready, you can page Miss Knox. I know she's very eager to get her vitamin boost.
I'll prepare for her arrival.
So did Dr. Sorensen manage to get Sierra Knox's phone number? I heard him arguing with that Kronstadt lawyer earlier.
No, didn't have any luck. Once he's done with that other driver, he'll just have to use the intercom and call her over the PA system instead. She should be able to hear it just fine.
How are we doing here?
Yeah, relax, Doc. I know you've got Sierra Knox coming in for that fancy IV vitamin boost. I'm doing my best here, all right?
When you think about it, a paramedic is kind of the opposite of a hitman.
Go, go, go. Think of running water. Breathe is good. Okay. Breathe helps.
The race is entering its final lap, 47. The race is over. Sierra will be coming off the track any time now.
Thank you.
Paging Miss Knox. Paging Miss Sierra Knox. The doctor will see you now. Miss Knox,
you take my temperature.
Let's do this.
That makes sense.
Where'd you want me?
Miss Knox, come on in. Have a seat and relax.
So, what's on the menu? Something that'll take care of this hideous pain in my neck, I hope.
I promise. Once I'm done, you won't feel a thing.
So what's in this thing anyway, Doc?
Mostly floral extracts.
Both targets down. Well done, 47. Head for an exit, and we'll speak again soon.